let's go talk to, what's his face? I can't fast travel from in here. I'm like, what do you mean I can't fucking fast travel? Let's read some more of these early Steam reviews. What do I think of the game? Is it what you'd hoped it'd be? There's a couple of things I don't care much for, but I mean, if you're looking for like an overall rating, 9 out of 10, 9.5 out of 10. It's pretty close. It's not 100% perfect, but it's pretty good. Like the crafting system, I don't it's nice. I like how they got rid of the repair, which is super awesome, great. But I don't care much that the random merchants can walk into my settlement and equip my power armor and then just walk out like they didn't do anything. I was genuinely upset when that happened. I threw it up on the internet. I tagged Bethesda in like my Twitter post about it. I shared it on Facebook, just trying to see if anyone else had that ever happen. And I'm waiting on a response. Like, how the fuck do I get this back? Because it had my T51B, which is like the better power armor. It's not the best one, I know, but it's better than the shit that you start out with. And I had it, like, customized with Vault Blue.
The latest hairstyles from the upper stand. Don't walk outside the wall undefended. High quality protection for sale.
Free shopping. Remember, I don't serve scents. Supplies are just for humans.
I'll take a look, sure.
A bit of everything.
Everything I got will keep you safe.
Sure. Let's see what you have.
Self-defense at its best.
You're looking at a lot of thumb down reviews on Steam. Well, I heard that a bunch of people are like butt hurt over the whole thing. Just Fallout 4, since they changed so much stuff. That they don't like it in general, since it's not the same exact game. Which is pretty stupid, but
what do you say?
Oh.
Okay. Maybe this will be a fresh start.
Sweet. I just recruited a hobo.
that vault dweller? From the paper.
We got small arms, long
I arms. I am that vault dweller from the paper.
Ellie? Are you here?
Nick? Oh God, it's really you.
Well, it's hard to mistake this mug for anyone else.
You keep laughing at death. Someday, death's gonna laugh back.
Not as long as I got a few friends to back me up.
You saved Nick, this agency, and my job. Thank you.
Pay me.
Can we get started on my case?
Oh, of course. There's just a small clerical thing we need to clear up. Here. Every cap we agreed to for finding him. Plus a little something extra. You know, if you're looking for work and don't mind putting on the detective hat, Nick sure could use a new partner.
Whoa. One case at a time, Ellie. Our new friend needs our help first. All right, let's get down to business. Take a seat. Make yourself comfortable.
I'll take a seat after I'm done looting your office. That only seems fair. What the hell does a synthetic man need Stimpax for? Sightings of a man dubbed the Mysterious Stranger have been popping up sporadically across the old U.S. for years now. Best case, the man's an amoral lunatic. Worst case, a prolific serial killer. All anyone knows is his M.O., appearing suddenly, killing without remorse, disappearing without a word. The Stranger has no known accomplices, no clear method for selecting his targets, no calling cards left behind. Sightings range from the NCR all the way to the East Coast, stretching back decades. Now he's come to the Commonwealth. Last thing this place needs is another psychopath running amok. Time to start putting together the pieces to put this one away. Description: human, male. Outfits vary, but most of the recent sightings describe a large overcoat and a fedora. Guy has taste, I'll give him that much. One man, multiple men, a ghoul with a minimal scarring, might explain the long passages of time between sightings. Appears and disappears suddenly, suggesting a preternatural infiltration abilities / access to advanced cloaking tech. All but the earliest description suggests the Stranger uses only conventional arms, making infiltration training more likely. Perps like this make me wish the Institute had sprung for thermal detection before giving me the boot. Sighting locations: Commonwealth, confirmed. Capital Wasteland, confirmed. NCR, old rumors. Shady Sands, really old rumors. The detective is looking into the mysterious stranger perk. That's funny. I'm glad they're acknowledging it. It makes me laugh. Disappearing act, Earl Swing, 25 year old bartender at Dugout Inn. One of the owners noticed that Earl had been to work for a few days. Security was called in, no investigation, of course. The Institute took him as the unofficial word about town, like always. Vadim came into my office half drunk with a sob story about how he and Earl went way back, and then he just believed that Earl would get snatched up by the big man. My gut says he's right. Earl didn't have any enemies, at least none with the motive enough to kill the guy, not living with anyone either, so I'll have to see if Vadim or someone else at the dugout has his keys. I'd rather not have to explain to security why I was picking the lock on Earl's door if I slip up and get caught in the act.
The Earl Sterling case. Apparently Earl just up and disappeared one day. No one's seen him since.
I've been meaning to put Earl's case to bed for a while now. There we go.
Huh!
What's your take on the case, Ellie?
On Earl? Well, he didn't have any enemies, that's for sure. Someone would have to notice you're alive first.
And Earl didn't exactly have the charisma to inspire any crimes of passion. What's that leave us?
I don't know, Nick. It can't be the Institute, right?
Guess that's up to you to find out.
The Marty Bullfinch case. Marty was Nick's partner.
Emphasis on the was. He must have been some kind of desperate to come to us for help after all this time.
Well, Marty and I never exactly saw eye to eye. Mostly because he was usually passed out on the barroom floor.
Aw, come on, Nick. Think of the good times.
What, when he quit?
Yeah, that's the one I'm thinking of.
Yeah, I'm a little upset that they don't have the karma system, but, you know, they took out some stuff and they added some others. It's still Fallout at its core, you know. There's not really a morality system, though, from what I can tell anymore. Just companions like you, or they don't. Some of the other Steam reviews. My fucking computer runs this at 9 frames per second, and it's still amazing. The day has finally come. You can have a romance with a ghoul. 11 of 10 would touch that filthy penis again. Fallout New Vegas, you can have sex with a cowboy ghoul hooker, which I'd totally done. Spent 30 minutes creating my personal wife. Watched her die in less than 10 minutes. 10-10 would watch wife die again. Yeah, I was so pissed at that because I made my wife, like, well, after my wife. So, you know, I was like, oh, this will be, you know, cool. We'll get to do stuff together. Then I get a shot in the fucking face. Which, by the way, both of us were white. Caucasian, you know, male, female. Our baby, 100% black. 100% black. I'm looking for Sean, and I'm 100% sure he's not even my kid. Stop reading the reviews, buy the game already. At first I was afraid. I was petrified. Then I gave up on this bit and played more Fallout 4. Upon finding my first batch of mole rats, my dog proceeded to fly up into the air and disappear. A few seconds later, all the mole rats were dead and he was sitting in front of me, wagging away. Even the glitches in the game are charming as hell. The babies are supposed to be different in everyone's game, yeah. But my baby was fucking black. And both of us were white, so unless I'm like half black and don't know it, Nora was definitely fucking cheating on me.
When you're trying to find someone who's gone missing, the devil is in the details. Tell me everything you can, no matter how painful it might be.
We're looking for my son, Sean. He's less than a year old. Why would anyone take him?
Good question. Why your family in particular? Why an infant? Someone would be taking on all of his care, and a baby needs a lot of it. What else can you tell me?
We were in a vault when it happened. Vault 111. It was some kind of cryo facility.
You were on ice, huh? More importantly, you were underground, sealed up. A lot of obstacles to get through just to take one person. Anything else you remember?
My wife was murdered. She was trying to keep them from taking Sean, and they just...
It's okay. You don't need to say anything more.
So, we're talking about a group of cold-hearted killers, but they waited until something went wrong to resort to violence. Well, that confirms it. This isn't a random kidnapping. Whoever took your kid had an agenda. There's a lot of groups in the Commonwealth that take people. Raiders, super mutants, the gunners, and of course there's the Institute.
So you think this Institute is responsible?
Well, they're the boogeymen of the Commonwealth. Something goes wrong, everyone blames them. Easy to see why. Those early model synths of theirs strip whole towns for parts, killing everything in their way. Then you got the newer models, good as human, that infiltrate cities and pull strings from the shadows. Worst of all, no one knows why they do it, what their plan is, or where they are. Not even me. And I'm a synth myself. A discarded prototype, anyway.
You're a prototype?
As far as I know. Never seen any other synth like myself. There's the older ones that are dumb as rocks and all metal, and there's the newer ones that are almost human. I'm somewhere in between.
You don't know anything about them? Really?
Some kind of security setting strips or blocks out those memories. And it's not just me. Any synth that gets trashed, left behind, or escapes the Institute has the same problem. Probably some kind of failsafe.
Either way, I need to find Sean.
You're right. The speculation is getting us off track. Let's focus on what you saw. What did these kidnappers look like?
I'll never forget that voice. Low and rough. Like sandpaper across your face.
Not much to go on, but a tough and commanding voice can get someone pretty far in the violence business. What else?
The man who killed my wife. He had a handgun. I didn't get a clear look at it. But that sound...
Could have been a large caliber revolver. Huh. I'm starting to get a clearer picture of the kind of man our perp is. Anything more you can tell me?
The woman was dressed in, I think it was a kind of hazard suit. The man had some sort of metal brace on his arm.
Maybe some kind of improvised armor? A lot of hired guns do that to look tough. The hazard suit is interesting. Not many mercs can afford something that fancy. What else do you remember about them?
One of them came right up to me. Bald head. Scar across his left eye.
Wait. It couldn't be. You didn't hear the name Kellogg at all, did you?
Who is he? Do you think he has Sean?
Way too big of a coincidence. Ellie, what notes do we have about the Kellogg case?
The description matches. Bald head, scar, reputation for dangerous mercenary work, but no one knows who his employer is.
And he bought a house here in town, right? And he had a kid with him, didn't he?
Yeah, that's right. The house in the abandoned West stands. The boy with him was around 10 years old.
It's Sean. It has to be. Somehow.
Don't jump the gun on me. You said you were looking for an infant, remember? That's over 9 years difference by my count. Look, maybe he has a son of his own. Maybe it's someone else's kid. Either way, they both vanished a while back. Let's you and I take a walk over to Kellogg's last known address. See if we can snoop out where he went.
Security doesn't really go to that part of town, but you two should still be careful.
I always am.
I'm gonna go with Old Faithful. I do like how you can name your weapons. I like that now. That's one of the things I definitely do like. I can name my 10mm pistol Old Faithful.
Commonwealth can pull that off.
Yeah, it doesn't make sense why he would leave me alive.
Here we are. Keep an eye out, will you? See if I can get this open. That's one heck of a lock. That's something to hide, Kellogg? Why don't you give it a try?
Wow, how the hell are you supposed to get this lock if you don't have the master lockpicking unlocked yet? I mean, I have it unlocked, but that's only because, you know, I generally go for, you know, unlocking terminals and
let's take a look around.
Shit first.
Kellogg must have left something behind.
He left this broom! This is evidence.
The place seems small to you. Figured a guy like Kellogg would think big. Nothing here. Did you check out that desk?
He had handcuffs next to his bed.
Right. Look for anything out of sorts. Switch. Button. Well, that's one way to hide a room. Look at this. All of
Gwinnett Stout beer, 44 caliber bullets, and cigars. San Francisco Sunlights.
Interesting brand. Won't lead us anywhere on its own, though.
Oh my god, there's two Nuka Quantums in here.
I wonder if Dogmeat could pick up the scent.
Say, that's not a bad idea. Some dogs out there in the Commonwealth can track a man for miles. Well, Dogmeat seems eager for the job. Why don't you let him have a whiff? See if he picks up on the trail. Before you head out, I know this is personal business. If you have to face Kellogg on your own, just say so.
Any words of wisdom?
Kellogg really is the one who kidnapped your son. And he's dangerous. But so are you. You don't need to be afraid of him or anything else the Commonwealth throws at.
Except for Deathclaws. Always be afraid of Deathclaws. Bottom? Okay, fair warning. I don't know if either of you have cleared out Kendall Hospital. But as soon as you get to Kendall Hospital, you best have a pretty good set of weaponry and a lot of meds. Because there's a Deathclaw at the bottom of it and you cannot escape it. It is a death trap, in the most literal sense.
I want you with me on this, Nick.
All right. Let's get that bastard. This is your show from here on out, okay? You say jump, I'll say how high. Hey, you mind keeping an eye out for a second? Gotta run a diagnostic. Whew. Thanks. What'd I miss?
I don't see any actual guns in here.
Hey.
I'm all ears. Looking for something?
I like how he smokes, even though he's a robot. He said, at least we still have the backup when he left you alive, so that must mean something. That's true. Thank you for pointing that out.
Dogmeat. Get the scent, boy. Take me to him, boy. Take me to Sean.
I like how Dogmeat will be your follower, regardless of how dicky you are.
Hanging out with Valentine, huh? Good for you. Nick is good people. You know what I mean.
Nikki's good people. One thing that I haven't fully I wish they would do more with the settlements, like explain to you how to do everything. I know there's like the help section that you can just sit down and read, but I kind of wish it was like a quest or something, or some sort of tutorial that you could do, because like they said that you can have trade routes between your settlements, but they didn't actually say how to do that. And I sent Piper on one, and I have no idea what I told her to do, and I think she's just walking to and from one place to another now constantly. Like, as far as I'm concerned, she's completely lost forever. Yeah, I'm definitely agreeing with you, Drunk. As far as Sean being aged some, because, you know, you were still in the You were still in that vault for a good chunk of time after your wife was killed. Where's Nikki? My Dogmeat. I'm a baby boy.
Kellogg must have stopped here. Search around, see if we can pick up the trail.
San Francisco sunlights.
Telling you, that nose is second to none.
Okay, boy, let's track him.
Who just takes a stop in the middle of, like, the Commonwealth to just smoke a cigarette next to some water?
I'll need your nose to track Kellogg, boy.
There you go, buddy. Where'd you get that teddy bear? Put the teddy bear down. Go find my son.
We gotta stick together, pal. At least until we find Kellogg.
Is Dogmeat glitched? There you go. This way? Is it this way? Dogmeat for my son! Maybe you can recruit the caravans that come through some of the settlements. Ten Pines had a caravan when I first went to it on the quest.
Kellogg's still out there. You've got to track him, boy.
There we go. Maybe it was just taking Dogmeat a long time to find. By the way, glowing mole rats? That's just terrifying. Oh my god, they're like eating me alive.
We'll be taking that.
Oh, there you are, Dogmeat. Doug is such a troll. What is that? Normally I would go investigate that, but kind of in the middle of a main quest story.
Another one of Kellogg's pit stops. Keep your eyes open.
I'm trying to inspect the blood splatter, but it won't let me. Dogmeat, I love you. Get the fuck out of the way.
Bloody bandages. Dogmeat can track this.
Okay, boy. Let's track him.
I'll need your nose to track Kellogg, boy. Kellogg's still out there. We've got to track him, boy.
Dogmeat? Come on, buddy. There we go. Dogmeat is trolling me. Wait, speaking of Dogmeat, where the fuck did he run off to? There you are. First you don't run quick enough, now you're running too fast.
We gotta stick together, pal. At least until we find Kellogg. I'll need your nose to track Kellogg, boy. Kellogg's still out there. You've got to track him, boy.
Any day now, Dogmeat. Come on. Just give it a little push. Just... There we go. I feel like this quest would be done a lot sooner if it wasn't for the fact that Dogmeat just, you know, he's got to sit down and take a break every now and then. For like 20 fucking minutes. That is a Yao guy. I'm not fucking around. Yugwai. I think that's the actually proper way to say it. Yugwai.
Dogmeat's found something. You know the drill.
I'm pretty sure I was looking right at it. and went to disarm it, and I could not.
We gotta stick together, pal. At least until we find Kellogg.
Didn't I give him a hunting rifle?
Hey.
I'll see what I can do. Here's what I've got.
I'm coming! That's fair goal. That's fair goal. Oh, there are so many. Well, of course one of them's legendary. Why wouldn't one of them be legendary? Two-shot, 10mm pistol? I have to upgrade that later. We have walked a long fucking way.
Tracking no mercenary. Exercise all extreme caution. Alert. Critical signs. Alert. Critical signs. Attention, assailant. Lower your weapons immediately.
What have we here?
Error. System corrupt. I can't feel my legs.
What happened here?
Error. Operator deceased. Threat level Omega. He killed us.
We're still on track. Hopefully he's not much further.
What is that? That is a death claw. Okay. We're gonna We're gonna quick save, just super quick. Just super, super, super quick. Dogmeat, you're going balls deep. I like your enthusiasm, but it's Deathclaw. You're gonna get your ass kicked, okay? That was a critical strike. Oh, do I have any more buff jet? Oh, thank God.
We gotta stick together, pal. At least until we find Kellogg.
Remember, keep your eyes open.
Yeah, for fucking Deathclaws, apparently. He's stuck in this railing. Any day now, Dogmeat. Don't tell me we're headed towards this hospital. Hospitals are never a good thing. Thank you. Best way to kill a Deathclaw, pop some jet. That is literally the only thing I can recommend.
What do you think, boy? Was this our man? Kellogg's still out there. We've got to track him, boy.
I hate bloat flies, they fucking, like, spew anus shit from their... I don't even... Legendary albino ragstag? I really want to shoot that. Aim for its right head. Are we on the map? We must have walked a long way. Yeah. Look at how far we've walked. Dogmeat's tracking this motherfucker down from, like, halfway across the Commonwealth. Did I set Nick on fire? My bad.
Is this the place? Is he in here, boy?
I knew Dogmeat would sniff our man out. Let's you and I take it from here. Give our four-legged friend a break.
Find a way into Fort...